Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2310, Charles Williams Improves Dynamic Arrays. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, here early in February, there's a great new product coming out, and I love this quote from Excel MVP Charles Williams. Once you've had a chance to use dynamic arrays for a while, you start to realize what new features would make dynamic arrays a bit more useful. Charles released an add-in, and after I had used it for about an hour, I wrote back to Charles. I said, it was a team of developers in Redmond took over a year to develop dynamic arrays. You've made them an order of magnitude better. How many developers do you have working on this? And Charles says, yeah, it was me working for about 3 weeks. In case you don't know Charles, here's a photo of Charles. He's a legend. I mean, he worked on the original IBM PC. You know, he says the bits of his code are still and the operating system that any of us are using today. Just amazingly smart guy. And his new speed tools introduce over 100 powerful fast calculating functions for Excel. And the ones that I'm going to show you today, these floating and static totaling for dynamic arrays, are just a piece of this. Now, you know, Charles would love to make millions of dollars from this, but that's not why he wrote it. I mean, he just says this needs to be in Excel, and he's offered it to the Excel team. But even if the Excel team would accept, I mean, with the red tape and bureaucracy, it'll take years. So in the meantime, yeah, you can buy this add-in from Charles. The link is down there in the YouTube description. All right, let's just talk about how cool dynamic arrays are, but you know the inherent problem with them. So right here, I have a formula that is going to change its size based on some input cells. There's a rand array function there that's returning everything. And you know this is great, but let's say we needed totals at the bottom edge of this, so I select all of my cells, plus one extra row, plus one extra column, alt equals to put those auto sum functions in. Well, that's fine, as long as that array stays current size. And this little nomenclature here, sum of D6 hashtag, well, that automatically grows, but that's just a single cell, right? So as soon as I change this to four rows, five columns, what's going to happen? I get a spill error, because it's the formula here says, hey, look, I need to write values, and you have totals there, so you have to go get rid of your totals in order to make this work and re-enter the totals. That's going to be miserable. So here's what Charles gave us. He said, well, hey, I'll give you a function called totals, like this, and what it does is it takes your array, and it puts, watch row 10, watch right here when I press enter, it puts the totals down there below the data. All right, so there's my rand array. And as the rand array grows, as we go from four rows to six rows, the totals automatically move with it. Isn't that cool, right? So it's always floating down there. And, you know, Charles figures, I guess, the total row is most popular, but what if you want a total column? We'll change totals to H totals, and we get a column at the end. What if you want a column, total column at the right-hand side and a total row at the bottom? Now we just wrap totals around H totals, and we now have the ability to put a total row and a total column below a dynamic array, even if that dynamic array changes size. So let's make this 8 rows by 13 columns, and the totals are sitting out there, you know, working, right? So there's 745, 745. Choose these, 402, 402. Right, choose the whole thing, it works on the fly, 5659, 5659. This is just one of the functions. It's funny, when Charles showed this to the MVP community, one of my favorite Excel MVPs, Roger Govier in Wales, says, Charles, that's fine, but I don't put my totals at the bottom. I always put my totals at the top and to the left. So Charles goes back into the development studio, comes out a few hours later with some columns of an array, and that'll allow Charles or allow Roger or anyone who likes the totals at the top to have a floating array up here and some rows for the floating total at the bottom. And again, this will change. So if we go to 11 rows and 9 columns, get rid of my little note there, then it will automatically extend with the range. Beautiful. Here's another one. So here's a filter function, and we're filtering to either team red or team, what is it, blue. So I choose either red or blue, and I get a different number of results return. And I want a total, but I only want totals on column 4 and column 6. So this formula, the totals formula, is very cool. It has the ability to exclude columns. And in exclude columns, I say, hey, don't give me totals on column 1, 2, 3, or 5. And now I get totals just on 4. And check this out. Haven't even tried this yet. Right now, it's defaulting to 9 equals sum. You'll recognize that's the arguments that are in subtotals and a lot of other things. So 1 for average, 2 for count, 3 for count numbers. All 11 functions are available there if you would need an average at the bottom or something like that. Hey, this is the point where normally I tell you to buy my book, and I do have a chapter in this book about Charles's ad, and I think it's that important. But today, I think you should go out and support Charles Williams. The other thing we're going to do is we're going to try and get an Excel.user voice going here to try and encourage Microsoft to include these, and sooner rather than later. That would be a really good thing. So go ahead, click that I in the top right-hand corner, and you'll get to a page where you can link out to Charles' site. Check out the new add-in that he just released this week. If you like what you see here, please subscribe and ring that bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the YouTube comments below. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.